Cathie Wood has been the ultimate Tesla bear or bull over the last couple of years. And she was literally mocked and ridiculed at one point. I remember when Tesla's stock was at like $200 and she was calling for a $5,000 Tesla stock price before the split. Newsflash, Cathie was right. Cathie's one of the smartest people on Wall Street. She's actually killed it with ARK Invest. Now,
Bitcoin bull as well.
Bitcoin, well, Cathie is the opposite of the Tesla and Bitcoin bears. She's an innovation bull. She understands that technology makes the world better. That people, if you're going to be underestimating the technology, you're probably going to miss to the downside. And the things are going to outperform your expectations rather than underperform your expectations. But that's a whole another case. So she recently did this interview with Real Vision. I think it's an episodic thing that Raul Paul and the Real Vision folks are doing with Cathie. And yesterday, there was one of the episodes were released. And Cathie basically zeroed in on the shortcomings of Wall Street, according to this Market Watch article. And she said that we need to be more specific around technology analysis. And her basic critique is that the Wall Street analysts are looking at it as a car company. They're comparing it to the car companies. Our own co-head of the Best Business Show research team just compared Tesla to the car companies. It's bigger than Tesla or bigger than Toyota and Volkswagen, all these other guys. But Cathie basically says, look, at today's post-split price, she believes that Tesla is going to hit $3,000. We're at $700 now, but she thinks it's going to go to $3,000. And she said, quote, we believe the reason there is such a big inefficiency in Tesla's valuation is the short-term time horizon of analysts and the wrong analyst following it. So one, the analysts that are following the stock are the wrong type of analyst. They don't understand the company that it is. And two is they have a short time horizon rather than a long time horizon. Exactly what we were just talking about. And so she believes Tesla is a multifaceted technology company, but it's only being covered by the auto analyst on Wall Street for the most part. And so she said, quote, Tesla is a technology company, but it's not just one technology company. She said, as she points to energy storage, robotics, artificial intelligence, and software as a service. So she says, we have three analysts building the Tesla model. Those analysts are not just auto analysts because, quote, we believe the number is going to $75 trillion plus during the next 5 to 10 years and probably will account for more than all of the appreciation in the equity markets because the other side of disruptive innovation is creative destruction. So the traditional benchmarks today are being increasingly populated by value traps, cheap for a reason, because they are going to be disrupted or destroyed. And what she's specifically talking about is this idea of overall disruption and innovative vision and the market capitalization and public equities focused on transformative innovation is about $7 trillion in 2019. It doubled in 2020 to $14 trillion. She believes it's going to $75 trillion. So if you take the public markets and you zero in on the actual technology disruption, where true innovation is happening with technology, it was $7 trillion. Now it's 14. She believes it's going to $75 trillion. And she's basically making the argument that Wall Street analysts have no clue what they're talking about when it comes to technology innovation. Now, I personally believe that the Wall Street analysts are pretty smart. They do a lot of work. They do tons of research. But when you look at a company like Tesla, if your auto analysts are the ones that are actually the ones covering it, and you're not looking at the robotics, at the battery technology, at things like artificial intelligence, full self-driving, all that stuff, you're going to miss majority of the value. Like the car itself is actually, in terms of having four wheels, a steering wheel, and an engine, that's not what the value of the company is. The value of the company is everything else that it empowers, and it's the technology. It's over-the-air updates. That's where the true value of Tesla is, not in a car.
You hit it right on the head.
Did I?
Yeah,
you should did. We should set up a little analyst, a little Wall Street analyst.
Our own expectations?
I mean, I'll put our research team up against any Wall Street analyst firm.
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you know, you two are geniuses over there. You guys got the Google machine. I don't, if you're at a Wall Street firm, can you just cite Wikipedia or Google in a report?
You know what's funny?
Is that allowed? What's funny, Joe? What is funny?
I got a problem with the whole non-Wikipedia thing. I think Wikipedia is okay, right? Like I see it. Yeah, it's a great starting point in a lot of sources, but it really bugs me when people, they attack Wikipedia often. And then when it's on their side and it's like the only relevant information they can find us, I'm like, oh, it was on Wikipedia. That's a good point.
Who does that?
it was a specific point about someone on the internet last night, but
somebody coming at you?
Yeah, someone came at me. They're like, you could have found this on Wikipedia. Yeah,
name names, let's
and
go.
I was like, that was inaccurate.
It's a nobody.
It was like a bot, I think, but
a bot came at you about Wikipedia?
Well, it wasn't a bot.
Rattled.
It got me a little rattled.
If you guys didn't know, Joe last night was sweating. Well,
there's
in
a
his
lot
bed.
Of people you gotta be careful about which ones you go after, which ones you stay, you know. You know the deal.
That's true. We're not going to get into the strategy as to who to punk and who not to. But last thing I want to talk about is the robo-taxi. If Tesla is successful in building a fully autonomous fleet of cars, they have the data advantage in terms of miles driven. And as we talked about, they have self-driving because you can press the button, take your hands and feet off of the car, and it drives. It may not be perfect. It may not always do every single thing that it needs to do, but it drives. They have to be the leader in terms of building a robo-taxi fleet, right? Like, they have the autonomy, they have the full self-driving, and then they have the cars and the aspirational brand. Who else is going to try to compete with them?